This module will focus on extended harmonies and chromatic alterations of harmonies that we have already studied. Specifically, we will be looking at the extended harmonies of the 9th, 11th, and 13th chords, alterations that can be made to the dominant harmony, and alterations that can be made to the mediant and submediant harmonies. These types of harmonies all developed out of dissonance, which became standardized as part of the harmony. These dissonances, which originally were analyzed as diatonic or chromatic non-harmonic tones, eventually became part of the harmonic language itself. Just because extended harmonies have more pitches or chromatic alterations does not mean that their harmonic function changes. These chords still function as either tonic, predominant, or dominant, depending on the root of the chord and the root motion of the progression. The first topic we will discuss is extended harmony. We have already extensively studied the seventh chord, which was a triad with a passing tone or suspension that eventually became part of a traditional harmony. The seventh is just an extra third stacked on top of the triad. We can create 9th, 11th, and 13th chords in the same manner by stacking additional thirds on top of the 7th chord. Before we look at the quality of the intervals that create these chords, there are a few things to keep in mind about extended harmonies. They are almost always in root position. This is because they lose their identity when they are inverted. They are mostly dominant harmonies. Again, just because the dominant is extended does not mean that it loses its function as a dominant. The 9th, 11th, or 13th is almost always the highest sounding pitch. Again, when this is not the case, the chord loses its identity and the extended harmony ends up sounding like a non-harmonic tone. Extended dominants can not only function as the dominant harmony within the primary key, but they can also function as an applied dominant harmony to another scale degree. Finally, extended harmonies occur in both major and minor modes. Let's look at how these harmonies are built. To keep things simple, we will look at the keys of C major and C minor. Here is the dominant triad harmony in C major. Its quality is major. When we add a third on top, we create the dominant seventh harmony. Its quality is major minor. We can add another third on top of that. Now we have a major minor seventh chord with an added major ninth above the root. We would analyze this chord as an uppercase or major 5 with a superscript 9. In minor, we start the same way. The dominant seventh is still major minor because we raise the leading tone. When we add the ninth, though, we have to take the key signature into account. In minor, we see that the ninth is now a minor ninth above the root. Oddly, there is no distinction between the Roman numeral of the 5-9 chord in major or in minor. It is still written as an uppercase 5 with a superscript 9. To make the 11th chord, we add another third. In major, we create a major minor 7th chord with a major 9th and a compound perfect 4th above that. The Roman numeral for a 5-11 chord is written like this. In minor, we create the same major minor seventh chord, but now with a minor ninth above. The 11th above the root is the same as in major, though, a compound perfect fourth. In minor, we write the Roman numeral the same as in major. Finally, we can create a 13th chord using the same process. In major, the 13th above the root creates a compound major third, and in minor, it creates a compound minor third. The Roman numeral in both modes is major 5 with a superscript 13. When part writing these chords, you have to omit something. There are too many notes to work with in a four-voice chorale texture. On a 9th chord, you omit the 5th. On an 11th chord, you omit the 3rd and the 5th. And on the 13th chord, you omit the 5th, 9th, and 11th. Again, these chords retain their function as extended harmonies if the 9th, 11th, or 13th is in the highest voice or has some kind of prominence. Otherwise, they tend to be analyzed as chords with non-harmonic tones. The next topic is the altered dominant. When dominant triads are altered, the 5th of the chord is raised or lowered. A dominant triad that has been altered can become an augmented dominant, or a dominant with a major 3rd and a diminished 5th. The Roman numerals are written like this. We can also alter a dominant 7th chord. When we raise the fifth, we create a dominant harmony with an augmented triad and a minor seventh. When we lower the fifth, we create a chord with a major third, diminished fifth, and a minor seventh. One other alteration can occur. We can lower both the third and the fifth of a seventh chord. This only happens on seventh chords, not on triads. We create a diminished triad with a minor seventh, otherwise known as a half-diminished seventh chord. A few things to remember about altered dominants. Obviously, because of the way they are named, this only happens to the dominant harmony. The alterations do not change the function of the chord. They are still dominant and want to resolve to the tonic. Just like extended harmonies, they can function as applied dominants to scale degrees other than the tonic. Finally, unlike extended harmonies, altered dominants can be inverted. The Roman numerals for the chords that are not augmented or diminished tend to get a little complex. The final topic is the chromatic mediant. This is an altered mediant or submediant chord, so it affects triads built on the third or sixth scale degree. Chromatic mediants are most often triads, but seventh chords can occur. They are most commonly written in root position. They can appear in both major and minor modes, and they most often proceed to or from the tonic harmony. They still function in the same manner as the mediant or the submediant. Use the context of the chords around them to determine their function as either tonic or predominant. In major, the following chromatic mediants are possible. A major sixth chord built on the lowered sixth scale degree, a minor sixth chord built on the lowered sixth scale degree, a major three chord built on the lowered third scale degree, or a minor three chord built on the lowered third scale degree. In minor, we can have the minor sixth chord, a major sixth chord built on the raised sixth scale degree, a minor sixth chord built on the raised sixth scale degree, a minor three chord, a major three chord built on the raised third scale degree, and a minor third chord built on the raised third scale degree. You may recognize the flat major six as a borrowed chord. Be careful with these chords in your analysis. Many chromatic mediants are spelled the same way as altered chords or applied chords. You must use the context of the other chords in the progression to determine if the harmony is functioning as a chromatic mediant, borrowed chord, or applied chord. Take some time to review the basic ideas behind each of these harmonies: extended harmonies, altered dominants, and chromatic mediants. They will become increasingly used in our study of Romantic, Late Romantic, and Impressionistic music.